like this, the fourth, the fifth, the mighty fallen.
This was Alice singing Hallelujah.
The baffled king composing Hallelujah.
A recording her parents wanted to share as they thanked family, friends, and strangers for their support.
I have been numbed by shock and grief. I have felt outrage and anger at the loss of her life and unbelievable sadness at the emptiness that has been left. I have racked my brains with all the what-ifs of that day, anything that might have stopped this random, incomprehensible tragedy.
And it's not just where you lay your head, it's not just where you rest your head.
The music was performed by her school teachers, remembering her love of music, a passion she shared with her father.
The open mics, the playing together, exploring nature, saying I love you to each other, those things and so many more will never happen now.
Earlier this month, a private funeral was held for the 14-year-old, but this memorial was in recognition of the efforts made by the community. Those like Jane Roberts, who tied yellow ribbons across West London when Alice disappeared and tended to flowers left when she was found dead 4 weeks later.
I think it was a comfort in a funny way, yeah. It was a comfort. Because she wasn't forgotten, you know, we still had Alice in our minds.
Your life changed ours, so now your love survives.
And local leaders have promised a lasting memorial in the future.
We need to let Alice's family have some privacy to grieve and try to come to terms with what's happened. I think it probably might be appropriate when there are anniversaries next year to perhaps think about permanent memorials.
Investigations are still being carried out into Alice's murder and the death of the prime suspect Arnis Alkhans. But this was a chance to celebrate her life, a teenager who was always so modest about her talents. Rhiannon Mills, Sky News.